Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes in the Sky. What's up this week? First, let's talk about the supermoon that occurred Sunday.
In astronomy news, the so-called supermoon was just as large as it always is when the moon is at perigee.
Okay, great talk. The Perseid meteor shower peaks on Wednesday morning, August 13th, just after midnight Universal Time. While the greatest activity for Perseids occurs then, or during late evening on the 12th for North American observers, there will be substantial meteor flashing across the sky the day or two before and after the peak as well. So even if your skies don't cooperate on the night of the peak, Perseids can still be seen before and after, just not as many. Plus, big, bright problem. The moon. Yes, that supermoon that occurred on Sunday will be a waning gibbous phase hanging around in the post-midnight skies. And that happens to be the best time to see the flashes of light from the bits of dust left over from Comet Swift-Tuttle as it sheds material while orbiting the Sun every 133 years. So despite the high ZHR, or zenithal hourly rate, of 90 meteors per hour for the Perseids, the moon's light will interfere with seeing many of the fainter ones. Look for the second magnitude and brighter streaks of light, which may occur once every 5 or 10 minutes at the peak. Yes, you'll need patience to see the Perseids this year, but to increase your odds of seeing more, get comfortable, wear warm clothing, and ideally sit on a chair with the moon at your back, or at least to the side, then look generally northeast and overhead. Fortunately, there are more naked eye objects to see this week. More on that momentarily. And now this week's dark sky fact. A popular phrase is, I slept like a baby. Well, if that's the kind of sleep we would want, why do we allow so much light to exist at night? To sleep like a baby, or for babies to sleep better even, we ought to be turning off indoor lights and shielding, aiming down, or putting motion detectors on outdoor ones to reduce light at night.
Extra, extra, Aphrodite and Zeus meet in the sky!
The ecliptic is the imaginary line in the sky that the Sun traces as Earth revolves around it. The rest of the planets are largely on the same plane as Earth's orbit, so we see both the Moon and the major planets on or near this same line. Early in the morning this week into next, Jupiter begins its ascent into the morning sky in a big way, with a wonderful conjunction near the rapidly descending Venus. Clipping along at almost 3/4 of a degree per day, Jupiter scampers upward along the ecliptic, meeting Venus in the sky on the morning of August 18th. The planets will appear so close together that you can see both in the same telescopic field of view. At closest approach around 4 a.m. Universal Time, the planets will be just 0.2 degrees apart, and yet their actual distance from each other will be over 400 million miles. Venus, despite being an inferior planet to Earth, is also on the opposite side of the Sun, just like Jupiter, so its disk is almost fully illuminated, as Jove's is from our perspective. The brightness of the two planets together may cause them to appear like a single, very bright point in the sky, as they are the brightest objects after the Sun and Moon. Get up early and check them out this week. The next time these planets get this close to each other again isn't until June 30th, 2015. On the evening side of things, Mars is making a beeline underneath Saturn's position. Remember, while the planets orbit on or near the ecliptic, they aren't exactly on the same plane. So while Saturn is well above the ecliptic, settled in between the brighter stars of Libra, Mars marches well below it. It lines up in a planet-star-planet arrangement on August 18th, which should make for a nice wide-field photo opportunity. By the following weekend, the red planet is about 3.5 degrees south of the ringed planet. What's more, the dwarf planets Vesta at 7th magnitude and Ceres at 8th are both just to the west of Saturn and Mars. For more information on seeing meteors better and finding all these major and minor planets this week and next, be sure to visit eyesonthesky.com. Did you like this video? Please subscribe on YouTube and consider sharing with others on social media sites so we can continue educating about light pollution and help reduce this problem, not only so we can see more stars, but also improve our health. Thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.